Ahsoka Tano, once despised on internet forums in the early days of Clone Wars, has become a fan favorite and one of the most powerful Force users we've ever seen in Star Wars canon. So today, I want to go over her in-universe scaling and see just how well she stacks up against her contemporaries. Ahsoka Tano was a youngling brought to the Jedi Temple by Jedi Master Plo Koon, and after training alongside her fellow younglings, she was eventually assigned a master, Jedi Knight Anakin Skywalker. Seeing weak areas in both Anakin and Ahsoka, Grandmaster Yoda paired these two together, hoping they would help each other grow and mature in various aspects where Yoda felt that they were lacking. Being immediately thrust into the Clone War as a commander, Ahsoka was forced to learn quickly. In her first duel, we see Ahsoka take up arms against the Sith assassin Asajj Ventress, and unsurprisingly, she loses. After all, Asajj is a match for Obi-Wan and Anakin at this point, but Ahsoka grows at a rapid pace. Shortly after her encounter with Asajj, Ahsoka is forced to battle the terrifying General Grievous, and while Grievous only uses two lightsabers in their confrontation, Ahsoka does decently, saving multiple clones and even overpowering the deadly cyborg at one point while being choked by him. Even though Grievous was only using two sabers and he did force Ahsoka to flee, it's not a bad showing, especially for a Padawan this early in their journey. After all, Grievous consistently puts characters like Obi-Wan in sticky situations and duels nearly a dozen Jedi Masters throughout the Clone Wars. With her single lightsaber, she goes on to fight Ventress again alongside Jedi Master Luminara, and eventually duels a mind-controlled Barriss Offee, a character that can keep up with Anakin Skywalker late in the series. But eventually, she adds a second Shoto lightsaber blade to complement her primary lightsaber. Under the direct tutelage of Anakin Skywalker, the renowned lightsaber duelist who at age 12 impressed Darth Sidious with his lightsaber skills, Ahsoka was able to continually become more and more of a threat to the Separatists during the Clone Wars. However, Anakin struggled to help Ahsoka make the most of her secondary blade, as Anakin was primarily a single lightsaber wielder. So, the greatest duelist in the Jedi Order, Grandmaster Yoda, eventually noticed Ahsoka's struggles and stepped in to assist, providing invaluable guidance, and he even helped her develop one of her signature defensive abilities that she would eventually use against her former master, Anakin Skywalker, but we'll get to that later. Eventually, Ahsoka duels General Grievous once again and performs much better, Grievous clearly going all out this time, using four lightsabers to her two. She tags him with a force push, and he slams her to the ground, each going blow for blow until Ahsoka retreated due to the mitigating circumstances. As the Clone War raged on, Ahsoka is eventually framed for the bombing of the Jedi Temple, and while Anakin was able to find evidence exonerating her, Ahsoka loses faith in the Jedi and abandons her title and status within the Order. And this is all despite the fact that the Jedi Council decided to officially knight her, showing that she had grown significantly from the beginning of the Clone War. However, she wouldn't stay away long. She was called back to deal with the sinister Darth Maul. And in my opinion, Ahsoka did very well, but Darth Maul is still above her in terms of skill and overall power. I believe this for multiple reasons. One, Maul blatantly overpowers her, and Ahsoka is left exhausted by turning his momentum against him, so I mean that's pretty blatant. Two, Maul is clearly attempting to lure her to the dark side, not kill her outright. If he could land like a dismembering blow or something like that, her suffering could lead her to the dark side. And three, Darth Maul isn't at his best here. He's not as invested in the fight against Ahsoka as he would have been against Anakin, while Ahsoka is at her best fighting for her friends. I don't say this to downplay Ahsoka at all, but I think at this point Maul has the slight edge over her, and based on this performance, I'd put her squarely in or above Obi-Wan's tier. After facing Darth Maul and surviving the Jedi Purge known as Order 66, Ahsoka joins the early rebellion as Fulcrum and crosses paths with Kanan Jarrus and Ezra Bridger, two Jedi working with the rebellion as members of the Ghost Crew. Alongside this group, Ahsoka battles against two Inquisitors and just embarrasses them outright, showing us just how much Ahsoka has really grown. After all, Darth Vader is able to dominate the Inquisitors in a similar fashion. Eventually, the Ghost crew is drawn to the ancient world of Malachor, where she crosses sabers with Darth Maul yet again and battles against the Inquisitors one last time. But her biggest test was yet to come. After the arrival of Darth Vader, Ahsoka takes it upon herself to battle it out against the Dark Lord of the Sith, who at this point would be nearing his prime. By 14 BBY, Vader had surpassed the peak he reached as Anakin Skywalker. Quote, his injuries had deformed his body, left it broken, but they'd perfected his spirit, strengthening his connection to the Force. And just 2 years after dueling Ahsoka, Vader reaches a new peak. Quote, the Vader of A New Hope is much more self-assured. He's angry, but never quite out of control. Though he takes orders from Tarkin, based as much on a begrudging respect than any issue of rank, Vader is at the height of his power, and it shows in every interaction he has, and even in the way he stands. Not only is she able to keep up with Vader in lightsaber combat, flipping around him, using her speed to her advantage, and utilizing the skills Anakin and Yoda had taught her, she's also able to briefly match his strength at various points throughout the duel. But how strong is Darth Vader? We can't really figure out how strong Ahsoka is without figuring out how strong her strongest opponent is. Well, there are multiple ways to approach scaling in Star Wars canon, depending on how you scale the verse, each being valid in their own unique way. First is just raw numbers, calculations based off of feats performed in the universe. In a great video done by the game theorists, they calculate his lifting strength at 136,586,969.32 kilograms, or 301,122,722.4 pounds, putting Darth Vader in small city level in power scaling terms, which is pretty powerful. Additionally, his force barrier can resist dozens of proton torpedoes, which exceed 1.253 gigatons of force, which is large mountain level. But there are possibly more hyperbolic statements like these, which state that Vader is more powerful than the Death Star, and if you really want to get nuts, you can scale him relative to Darth Sidious, as Vader was able to completely knock him off his feet and hold him against a wall, and Sidious is able to call on all the dark power of the Force and is a literal vessel of all the Sith's power, making him a universal level threat. As the sun, the embodiment of the dark side of the Force, could tear apart the fabric of the universe itself. So, I mean, I'll let you guys decide which you think is more valid, small city to large mountain, large planet level, or universal. Either way, Ahsoka contends with Vader, and while we don't see a cool Force clash like Obi-Wan and Anakin do in The Revenge of the Sith, we know for a fact that Jedi and Sith amplify their base stats with the Force, making them much stronger and faster than they normally would be. Also, there are multiple statements that Vader was not holding back against Ahsoka, who was really one of the last pieces of his former life that he'd like to be rid of forever. He was lying to her when he said the Emperor would show her mercy. Here's a quote from Dave Filoni himself. She is not an opportunity like his son. The idea of being Vader's son begins with, he is mine. When Vader says to Ahsoka, we need not be adversaries, the Emperor will show you mercy, that is a lie. And just for consistency, here's a quote from the recently released Star Wars book. Vader attempts to slay Ahsoka without mercy, but is thwarted by the explosion of the temple that releases great torrents of Force energy. And speaking of this explosion, Darth Vader absolutely tanks it, and when calculated, the force of this blast comes out to 9.4 kilotons of TNT or town level. If you want all the calculations that I've mentioned in this video, those will be linked down in the description. However, Ahsoka does not tank this attack. She is grabbed by a future version of Ezra, who drags her into the World Between Worlds, a realm with pathways between the past, present, and the future. While in the World Between Worlds, Ahsoka comes face to face with Darth Sidious, who is attempting to use this realm for his own nefarious deeds. Sidious sends out a torrent of Sith fire that Ahsoka is able to absorb and redirect, using what seems to be a reference to Tutuminus, an ability within Star Wars Legends that allows for energy absorption. Although Tutuminus is not a term ever used in canon, Jedi do perform energy absorbing feats throughout canon. This feat just gives more consistency for Ahsoka being relative to the top tier characters of the Star Wars universe, such as Darth Vader and Darth Sidious. Even Dave Filoni confirms as much. Quote, "We all felt Ahsoka, the only person that could really match her in this time period, blow for blow, would be Vader or the Emperor." As for other abilities, Ahsoka pretty much has all the standard Jedi toolset, including force barriers, pushes, pulls, mind tricks, etc. But being a Togruta, she has the ability to sense space ultrasonically, which enhances her spatial awareness, making her an even more deadly opponent. Finally, while still alive, Ahsoka is able to join other Jedi of the past to help amplify Rey, granting her the power to destroy full power and dyad-enhanced Darth Sidious. So all in all, Ahsoka is very, very, very powerful, one of the strongest characters that we've ever seen in Star Wars canon. What do you guys think of Ahsoka? Were you impressed by her feats, or do you think that she could do more? Do you expect to see more from her in the future? As I stated earlier, she's not dead by the time of the Rise of Skywalker, so the potential is limitless. Also, let me know who you want to see a video on next down in the comments, and remember the motto, it's Ahsoka Tano over everything, and I'll see you guys next time.